Hi Earthlings, welcome back to another video. If you are new here, my name is Adede. I talk about thickening thin fine natural hair and everything about thin fine natural hair, basically because my hair is thin fine natural hair. I've started this journey few years back and I've come a long way that my hair has gotten a little bit thicker, because I know a lot of new subscribers always point out to me that your hair is not thin and yada 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 blah blah blah, but my hair is not thin anymore because I've been working very hard towards thickening it up the past years. And I want to share a tip with you today about how I got my hair thicker, even though that I've been sick for maybe the past 6 or 7 months, that I kept on working on my hair and kept on growing it and everything. That is also because that I have a lot of history that I set a good basis to keep on maintaining the good things that I did to my hair in the past. So keeping my hair healthy and keeping on growing it the past 6 months that I have been sick have also been easy. I didn't have to do a lot of things, but I did have to do something, because otherwise your hair is going to break off. This video is being sponsored by Skillshare. Skillshare is an online learning platform with over thousands of classes that you can follow about basically everything. At this moment, I'm really keen on Ayurvedic, so I am everything Ayurvedic. So right now I am following multiple classes on Skillshare about Ayurvedic so that I can improve my knowledge about Ayurvedic, how it can help me from within, and also how I can apply it to my hair, etc. Skillshare has been generous enough to give the first 1,000 subscribers 1 month free of Skillshare premium account. So the first 1,000 people who click on the link in my description below will have access to this. Enjoy and let's learn together. So in this video, I'm going to share with you what I have been doing the past 6-7 months that has kept my hair growing longer and thicker, even though that I have been sick in bed for this whole period. So before I go ahead with this video, I want to shout out my own products. If you don't know about them, I have my Aiding Crest symbols, which I will link down below. But I also have natural hair products now. I have my recent product, which is my ebook about Ayurvedic for natural hair. And I also have my Ayurvedic recipes, and I also have my natural hair regimen. If you want to use it for, if you want to use it as a basics for your own natural hair, I will link everything in the link below. Yeah, so let's go ahead and get straight into this video. So the number one thing that I have been doing during the period I have been sick, or yeah, during the period I have been sick, is definitely protective style. That is something that you definitely cannot leave out, because if you are sick, you obviously cannot be doing your washing routine and your moisturizing routine and the conditioning routine and all those things. That is a little bit too much, and you also have 2 kids that you have to attend to. So the one thing that I have been doing is protective style. But as we all know, in the process of protecting your hair, you also have to keep on moisturizing your hair and keep on doing things your hair and keep on doing things to your hair to maintain the moisture and everything in your hair. Otherwise, you take out your protective hairstyle and your hair will definitely break off. So the number one product that has definitely been helping me in this period is definitely my fenugreek and my moringa oil. Well, the number one product is definitely my fenugreek. I love this product because I think out of all the Ayurvedic products, this is the number one product that I think that fits my hair needs. I've seen me wanting to thicken up my hair, and I've seen a lot, and I mean a lot of growth using fenugreek on my hair. And the one thing that I like about fenugreek is that you can use it in multiple ways, and I like to use it as simple as possible, because even without me being sick, I don't like to complicate things. So you can imagine me being sick, I would even like to keep things simple as possible. I just use it as a hair spritz. So when my hair is in the protective style, when I have all my braids in and all those things, I just go in every now and then and spray the fenugreek on my scalp, and I also go on my hair length and spray it there, and then I seal it off with my moringa oil, which you all know that I love. I definitely love the fenugreek moringa oil. Sorry, I also love fenugreek, obviously. And fenugreek has proven to me to be really good Ayurvedic hair product that suits my hair needs. It's also known to thicken natural hair. It has vitamin A, K, and C in it. It's known to clear dandruff on your scalp. It's known for scalp issues. It's also known to definitely thicken thin, fine natural hair. So fenugreek is, for all those reasons, a suitable product for my hair, and that is why I love it so much. And apart from that, you know, sometimes you have all these products and you read all these good things about it and you use it on your hair and it doesn't do what it says that it does. But with fenugreek, I just noticed that it just does what it says that it does. And what I love about it is it's just really simple. Like I said, I only use it in a spray form because I really don't have time to be blending it and using it for deep conditioner and all those things. It's not like I don't even have time. I don't have the energy to do that. So while I was sick, I didn't have the energy to deep condition and all those things anymore. So basically what I did is keep my hair in my protective style and go in every 2 days, every 3 days with a fenugreek, spray my scalp, spray the length of my hair. I don't soak in, it's not soaking wet spraying, just spritzing it. And then I go ahead and seal all the moisture in with my moringa oil. I also seal the moisture in my scalp. I have a video where I show you how I seal the moisture in, also in my scalp. So I will link it up here somewhere for you guys to see. So that is pretty much it. I think I also have a video whereby I show you how fenugreek has definitely helped my edges to grow, to fill in really well. I was born with no edges, basically. I didn't have a lot of hair. Well, that's why I have thin, fine natural hair, of course. But for the past year or something, since I've been using fenugreek, I have noticed that my edges has really filled in really well. If you have been following me, if you're really an OG, you will definitely know that I don't have a lot of hair on my edges. And right now, if you look at my edges, look. It has all been filled in thanks to fenugreek. I have a video whereby I show it into details. I will link it up somewhere so that you can see that. So yeah, that is my number one Ayurvedic hair product that I really love. It's my fenugreek. I wouldn't trade it for anything. I just love it and I just keep it really simple. I don't do any complicated things with it. Maybe in the future, if I have more energy and have more strength, I will definitely be trying different things out with it. So yeah. So if you want to know more about my recipe that I use with a fenugreek, I will link it here below. And I think it's also in my Ayurvedic book. And if it's not in my Ayurvedic ebook, it's also definitely in my top 7 Ayurvedic recipes that I love, definitely. On the top 7 Ayurvedic recipes, fenugreek is on top of those 7 Ayurvedic recipes because it is my favorite. So that's it, guys. Thank you very much for watching this video. And I'll definitely see you in my next video. For more information, I will link everything in the description below so you can see everything. So you should follow me on Instagram, on my Thin Fine Natural Hair Instagram, if you want to see more updates and short videos about my hair, etc. Thank you very much for watching and I'll see you in my next video. Bye!